So. Last time we talked about justice. Justice is a very complex idea because it has many components and they tend to interact with each other. Now, how to operationalize that is not something we can force. We cannot say, okay, this is the way justice should happen. But then, at the same time, if we think about the Bhagavad Gita, in the very first verse, the blind king, Dhritarashtra, is asking his charioteer, Sanjaya, "Oh Sanjaya, please tell me about the war that is being fought between Pandavas on one side and Kauravas on the other." Not just that, he says something more. He says, "Dharma Kshetre Kurukshetre," that is, on the field of justice, on the field of Dharma. Now, what is this Dharma or justice? We have to understand that it does not mean a common sense notion or a common sense definition of justice. What Dhritarashtra is mentioning here is justice at its highest level. It's a concept, but not just a concept. It's also the highest manifestation of an ideal. So, what is it? What is justice? To answer that, we really need to look into the text of the Bhagavad Gita, especially the 11th chapter, which we shall do in the next session. For now, let it suffice to say that justice involves two components. One is morality, you know, a foundation of morality ensures good justice. And two, a process, a continuous balancing and rebalancing process that tells us who we are, thereby solving the identification problem, which we call the identity crisis, and at the same time telling us who other people are, thereby solving the community problem, that is, engendering respect. Hence, the concept of justice, as expounded in the Bhagavad Gita, needs special attention. Thank you very much. हरिओम प्रणाम टू ऑल।